What's up, everybody? It's your boy Whisker, and you're watching Sub Urban Nerd, this channel where I give my nerd views on today's nerd news. Well, today's nerd news is going to be dealing with Black Panther, Wonder Woman, and aliens. Well, alien franchise, at least. Well, the first topic on a nerd rundown is going to be talking about Kendrick Lamar and how he's actually going to be the producer on the Black Panther album soundtrack for the Black Panther movie coming out February. And he's actually going to be working with Top Dog Entertainment founder Anthony Tiffith, and he's going to be basically collabing on making a whole album for this movie. And we haven't seen this in a while, because a lot of times, a lot of movies, they come together and they bring they make a soundtrack, but the soundtrack's pretty much dealing with already established songs, and then they're just bringing it onto it. Like, say, Guardians of the Galaxy was a bunch of old songs that they put onto it. Same thing goes for a lot of other movies, but like, not since the days of like maybe Waiting to Exhale and all these other movies back in like 90s. 90s is when they used to do this a lot, where they used to have artists actually make songs for the movie, or make, like, I think maybe Boomerang or something like that. They would make full albums for the movie, and they haven't done that in a while. And that's one thing I'm kind of glad Marvel's trying to bring back into, because they're not known for their theme music whatsoever. Like, you know, DC, they're you know, they've got, even though their movies are nowhere near as good as Marvel, one thing they do have is their theme music. Like, Wonder Woman, you've got them. We know that. When we hear that, we know Wonder Woman, you know? Sort of, Superman has his theme music, even Batman has his theme music. But the Avengers or anybody from Marvel, they really don't have that. But one thing that I'm, like I said, that I'm glad is they've already got the first single out for it. I'm gonna play a little bit for you. It's called All the Stars. And it's this is a song for Kendrick Lamar that he's the first single off the soundtrack for Black Panther. Now listen to it. I'm gonna stop right there, because like I said, I ain't trying to get this video kind of blocked and copywritten and all that stuff. So that's just a little taste of it. If you want, I'll put a link down in the description so you guys can listen to the full song. But like I said, I'm definitely looking forward to what Black Panther has the album, because this is the first all black cast that they pretty much made for the Marvel universe. And there haven't been that many movies like that that's mainstream, or like other than, you know, like I say, they have those indie movies, but this is mainstream all black cast. And not just all black cast, all great actors cast, like Michael B. Jordan, you got Chadwick Boseman, you've got all these actors that are just so well established, and this is all for just one movie. And the thing is, like, this is the first black superhero mainstream movie, like, not counting all those other ones, those comedies, Blank Man and all the stuff. No, this is a legit movie that I'm definitely proud of, because like I said, as one that's created his own black superhero, that we look forward to seeing my thing on a big screen. Well, that's all I'm going to talk about for that, but definitely check it out. Next, we're going to be having Wonder Woman. Patty Jenkins was talking about, you know, her the movie was promoting it or whatever, and they asked her questions, like, as far as what's going to happen in the next Wonder Woman movie. And she pretty much stated out like this: it's going to be totally different. Patty Jenkins says that in an interview with Entertainment Magazine at the Palm Springs Film Festival, Patty Jenkins, she got to bragging pretty much about her stuff, and she didn't say much. But she did say the sequel will be completely different. And as far as completely different, I don't know what she means, because you can't be too different from something that was so successful. Understand, you know, you got to kind of branch out, and you don't want to photocopy exactly of what you did. But I'm thinking when she says completely different, that it just means that it's not going to be in World War I. And it's going to be more focused on her personally, because I loved what she did in the first movie. And I don't want it to change too much, because like that the one scene that stands out to me that I'm always gonna remember was the dead No Man's Land, where she climbs up the ladder, and you've seen it in the trailer, where she has that shield up and she's just blocking it. Definitely, that's one of the standout moments of all superhero movies that I've ever seen. Definitely want them to keep it sort of in the same vein of what they did, but don't want them to diverge too far away from it. Because, like I said, what works, don't try and change it up too crazy, because then that's when everybody that comes back is like, what is this? Like, I don't understand. So, Patty Jenkins, please don't diverge too much from what you've made and the success that you have. I want you to be able to branch off and, you know, grow as a director, but don't go so out of the box that no one understands where this box is anymore. So, one of the things that's not too crazy, but it's sort of nerd news, is Logan is being nominated for Best Original Screenplay at the WGA's, at the Writers Guild of America. And that's a pretty good thing, because, you know, that even though it's a superhero movie, not a lot of them get this, not a lot of people, not a lot of these movies get the respect that they deserve when it comes to these awards, and definitely Logan is up there. It's great, even though Wonder Woman was a really good movie, but the way Hugh Jackman and Patrick Stewart, like the people, the way they portrayed Xavier and Wolverine, Logan, like it was art. So definitely good on those, and hopefully maybe in the Oscar times comes around, maybe they'll still get some props, you know. And then last of all, Ridley Scott. Of course, he's always talking about his Aliens franchise, but now the guy's talking some crazy. He's saying that there's no reason why Aliens should not be on the same level as Star Wars and Star Trek. Bruh, you're drinking. You are drinking heavily if you think the Alien franchise is on the same level. And the reason why I don't think it's on the same level, not that it's bad, but it's not for everybody. You know, Star Trek is for everybody, as far as, like, you know, kids and adults, whatever. Star Wars is for pretty much everybody. Aliens, where the things are eating people, horror, it's very graphic. Yeah, you can't have kids, so there's no way it could ever be on the same level. Respected-wise, yes, people know the name Aliens, but except you're never going to you can never compare, especially, like, even box office-wise, because it's just not, and as great as the movie is, you can't take your kids to it like that. If you do, maybe you're a bad parent. You know what I'm saying? So as far as that, I don't think it should be on the same level. On top of that, you don't have any people that you can market. You've got Ridley. I mean Ripley. You've got the lady, and that's it. With Star Wars, you've got things. Even Star Trek, you've got Kirk. They have so many iconic people. Aliens has one lady. Everybody else just dies. So how can you keep a franchise, like, in a relevance when there's nobody that people can relate to other than one woman? Even Terminator has, you know, Sarah Connor and you know, Arnold Schwarzenegger. But Arnold Schwarzenegger is bigger than life. You get what I'm saying? He's been in so many other movies that when you see Arnold Schwarzenegger, you relate to him already, regardless of what he's in. So, really, Scott, sorry, but I gotta disagree. Your thing should not be up on the same level as Star Wars. Like Star Wars right there, in Star Trek. And then Aliens, right at the cusp, you know? So pretty much that's all I got for today's nerd news. I'm going to be doing some more videos. Like, I'm going to do the review of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. because I watched that, and it was a great episode. And a review of the new Dragon Ball Super episode. And check it out. Remember to comment down below. Tell me if there's anything else you're going to want to talk about. If there's any questions you have for me, just let me know. So remember to subscribe over here. Check out my last nerd news. Check out the playlist for the nerd news. And remember, I'm Wes Grant. You've been watching Suburban Nerd, and you've just been nerdified. Catch you guys on the next video.